Welcome back to Let's Play Beyond Skyrim, Bruma. Sorry, the mic might have been a little too close to my mouth. But I think I fixed it. Carlia hanging out. Now, before I continue to my destination, I just want to show you guys I did it. I've cleared out all the extraneous stuff. Of course, now this stuff is probably stuck. Because I have to figure out how to get the gem again. Maybe I can use a console to command to get another gem, and I need to play it near him. Because I didn't realize what I was doing when I was playing it, it wasn't near him. And I didn't even know what the hell was going on at that point, so it wasn't really clear. We do have to go to Fort Pale Pass. We have a little thing there, and then Pale Pass is here again, and then Frozen Grotto we are going right now. And we need to decide how to deal with the Talos worshippers to the east of Bruma. I guess I'm doing that next. But first, Frozen Grotto, which is somewhat nearby. Right in the tummy. It's running. Is it? The pathing is messed up, isn't it? It's coming around this way.
Lady of Shadows. I live another day.
It's just a bear. Right, so we found vampires last episode over here at the gutted mine. Before that we were at Sador. So we're making our way to this frozen grotto. We were here not too long ago, Silvertooth Cave as well. So exciting to be look around. It really literally... I don't know what it is, guys. I played Skyrim for so long. I just got so tired of it. It took me literally 2 years to not be tired of it. And people kept asking me, play it again. Like, not play this, but play the actual game. I'm like, I did everything. I mean, the only thing left would be to play it all over again and take, like, the Imperial side or something. But I don't want to do that, because there's so many other games in the world, and there's stuff like this. Alright, so let's enter Frozen Grotto. So next is going to be... What the hell is it called? Another Skyrim mod. Well, it's a total modification. Okay, so it's there, obviously. But who else is here? It can't be just sitting here and we get it and we leave. I do not trust this at all. Ebony battle axe. I'll just take the gems and the gold, thanks. I am not the axe wielding type. This is a trap. This is just... Seriously? Something's gonna happen once we grab it. Leeks. Wait. Tomatoes. Oh, someone sleeps here. They're just not here right now. Failed? What? Why failed?
Well, well, if it isn't another adventurer. Come to return the heirloom back to its rightful owner.
Why'd I fail?
Well, I'm afraid the heirloom isn't real.
What?
You're a damned fool, though I can't say you're the first. Looks like you've just wandered into something well over your head. Now tell me, are you gonna sink or swim?
I'm gonna fly. Who the hell are you? Obviously you are Neldum Belloff, but I'm gonna ask you anyway.
I'm someone that isn't afraid to kill people that ask tedious questions. Now listen.
You can't kill me.
I have a dagger on my hip. It's laced with a deadly homebrew Dunric concoction. Luminous Rusla, Violet Coprinus, and a little bit of ground Animantium ore.
All you need
to know is that once this poison gets into your veins, well, I wouldn't be investing in any of your business ventures. So I suggest you cooperate with me.
I'm not afraid of your poison. How'd you sneak up on us like that?
A combination of stealth training, experience, and not being a clumsy oaf. That, and I kept a few invisibility potions in my satchel as a fallback.
That's the real answer.
Now, I think it's time we got down to business.
I'm not doing no business with you. What is it you want from me? Anyway.
Nothing too hard. Child's play. Good thing for you, eh? I have a package here that needs delivering to a certain Dunmer lady in Bruma. Quite the damsel, that one. No, and don't ask what's inside. None of your business.
You know I'm gonna look. You mean the woman I don't want to be agreeing to this. So hopefully by asking this, I'm not agreeing. You mean the woman that sent me here?
Well, if you're going to put it so bluntly, I'm afraid you've disappointed me. I was hoping we could keep the foreplay going a little longer.
Ew.
Yes, I mean Ella Moon Nethry. She's an associate of mine. Stone-hearted bitch. Suits me perfectly. Give her the goods, and you'll never hear from me again. Betray me, and our fledgling love will be short but sweet. Not even any love letters. How's that for bittersweet romance, eh? I'll let you work out the right choice.
I am gonna kill him, I just want to know what this is. Package. The package is sealed tightly. It should be possible to open it, but tampering it will likely anger its intended recipient. Are you sure you would like to open it? Yeah, I want to open the thing right in front of him. Because he's a jerk. Oh, skooma. That's all it is? Some skooma?
You are like this poor thing.
I don't think I'm even poisoned. Okay, his dagger does 22 points of stamina damage. Look at all this poison. Sweet. I've been wanting a few poisons, now I'm overweight with poisons. Potion of brief invisibility. Vigorous healing. Yeah. Well. The only thing you've done to me is take off maybe a couple dozen hit points and overweight me with poisons. Which are not in my body, but rather available for me to use. I really should put this stuff in my home. How overweight am I? Alright, did I drop this? Or said I was gonna drop it? I'm gonna drop it. Oh, I can't. That's right. I don't even remember what it's for. It's a quest item. So it's not weighing me down anyway. I hate always being overweighted by crap. Let's drop some of these eggs then. Oh, this is unknown. I can just eat this. Clovian nuthatch egg. Okay. Well, I think I'm gonna just drop all these white caps. That'll do it. I'm sure I'll find more. Well, that was fun. So, is this quest still up for the optional thing? I can go search her down. It's just, I'd want to tell her about that. What's the name? Alamu? So let's deal with the Talos worshippers first, anyway. The captain of the Bruma Guard, Adius, I think it's pronounced, Vilius, now wants me to help deal with some overly proud Talos worshippers to the east of Bruma. He told me that they are behaving too publicly, and while he doesn't want them to stop worshipping Talos, he needs them to be more subtle or risk the Thalmor tightening their grip on Bruma. I should head there and decide how I want to deal with the problem. Yeah, it stinks. I don't like being under the Thalmor's boot. Well, all this build-up, it took us forever to get here. And we were done in 10 minutes. Alright. I don't have any charge, right? That's running out. That's running out. I have a greater, okay. Let me use it there. And I think that's all I have is that one. Yep. No items. Maybe I can buy some, because I really dislike the act itself, trapping souls like that. That's a deer, right? I thought it was a person. Is. I could go around, or I could just try to get up this. Doesn't look too bad. Okay, so it's down there. Got it. Ah, feels great. Reminds one that they're alive. What? You cannot go that way? Wait. I can't go any other way? Are you serious? Why? They're right here. I literally cannot go that way. Alright, I don't think I can get back up, so get in mine and we'll go from there. That's weird. Pretty close now, anyway. Right over these rocks here. Oh, are they burning something like an effigy here? Let me just take a look. Oh no, it's just a camp. Camp of the Devout. Where are you going? Oh, they see me.
Hold that, traveler. Who are you? Are you with a Thalmor? Tell me. Now!
Do I look like a Thalmor? Oh, I like that sound. They put in the whole name like that. I am Amethyst Lunatari, and no, I am not with a Thalmor. I am a Breton, hailing from High Rock.
Then I suppose I can afford to stow my weapon. Hmm. I hope for your sake you're not lying. Besides, we've nothing to be ashamed of. Go on then. Ask whatever you like. Come and go as you please. But we'll be watching you.
Sounds intriguing. How long did this speech craft? I saw this when I was looking through this. 60 seconds only. I might take that. Just gonna look around here a little bit. Yeah, never seems to be anything.
Lucius Rodlin, sworn to Talos.
Well, hello there. How you doing?
Ira leads the congregation. I'm just a humble servant, a simple devotee.
Okay. Can you tell me anything else about yourself? Is it that cold out?
I'd prefer not to say too much. Gotta walk on eggshells nowadays. That said...
You guys aren't.
I used to live in Bruma. Narrowly evaded abduction. Heard Armion and his agents whispering outside my window.
Oh, Armion, yep.
Ira and I, we escaped in the night through the Bruma caverns. Bartram let us use his house as a quick escape route. Good thing the guard captain didn't know about the trap door in Bartram's house. Or I'm sure Armion would have too.
Oh.
Those were dark days. Dark days. Having to worship Tiber Septim in secret?
Everyone knows about that trapdoor. Sheesh.
Those old merry dogs will get what's coming to them eventually.
I hope so.
Do not forsake the god of man.
Okay. We'll keep that in mind. Oh, there, Olgruf. Chill wind.
If it turns out you are with the Thalm, I'll run you through myself.
Yeah, you sound like a couple guys over there in the Bruma Castle. What's your role up here?
I am the muscle. By looking intimidating, I scare away bandits. Those that have the brains their mother gave them, at any rate. And if any bandits, or wildlife, or Thalm, decide to try their luck, I send them swiftly onto Arcane.
Okay. Anything else you can tell me about yourself?
I'm not going to tell you my life story. You think I'm a fool? Okay. If the Thalmor know who my family are, they'll march them off in the middle of the night. Use them to try intimidate me. I'm a Talos worshipper. I follow Era. That's all there really is to it.
Okay, well, I'm not with the Thalmor.
If you sell us out to the Thalmor, I'll paint the Geras with your insides.
I'm afraid I don't...
I lead the congregation here.
I don't have that many
we
insides.
We worship Talos, and by
Good
the
morning.
Divines, we make no bones about it.
Make no bones about it. This is a funny thing for you to...
I am pretty handy with
what are you doing with Carlyle?
Don't get any funny ideas.
Listen, lady, take your hands off her. What the? Yeah, really. She's like, creepy.
We shouldn't need to hide. Soon, when the Thalmor are defeated, soon, we'll be able to step into the light.
Yeah, you sound rather optimistic. Wish I could share that. So let's take this plus 50 speechcraft and see if I can talk her out of something.
Can I help you?
Hopefully, I think time is not I don't even know. Tell me about yourself.
I've been faithful to Talos ever since I was first old enough to understand the tales. The Thum. To ascend to divinity.
Mm-hmm.
My grandmother would tell me the stories. Tiber Septim's great deeds. And his rise to godhood. A true inspiration. I believe in heroism. I believe in the resilience of man. Not the supremacy of elves. And I'm not about to let a damn treaty change that.
Okay. Well, can you tell me about your congregation? If time is passing now, it's gonna run off before I even get to, like, any kind of persuade option.
Not much to tell. We reject that fancy treaty the Emperor signed with those Dominion dogs. We believe in Talos. We worship Talos. And we'll keep worshipping Talos.
Talos.
Treaties be damned. Politics be damned.
Well, say his name right.
Thalmor abduction squats be damned.
You're sliding. How'd you end up out here?
Have you been living on the rock?
No.
Tell his worship's a crime now. Hermione and his justiciars have moved into Bruma.
Justiciars.
I didn't feel like sitting around in Bruma, like mammoths lining up for the milking. Turns out a few others had similar ideas. And so we left.
Aren't there threats to your safety up here?
Sometimes. But nothing we can't handle. Wolves, bears, the occasional troll, that sort of thing.
Yeah, makes
sense.
But
recently, we've been in a bit over our heads. Bandits, you know the sword. They came through here and took my amulet of Talos.
Oh, damn.
It means a lot to me. Next time you're exploring the wilds, mind keeping an eye out for it? We'll reward you as best we can within our means.
Huh. I'd be happy to help, just need something more to go on than somewhere in the wilds.
Thank you very much. Bandits probably have it stashed in one of their hideouts.
Find Eris Amulet of Talos and Serpent's Trail. Alright. Captain Adius sent me. Your Talos worship is causing issues.
Sending someone to stop us worshipping Talos? Has the captain gone mad?
Talos.
I always considered the captain a man of honor. A man of tolerance. Someone who refused to be a puppet to the Thelmor and the shameful demands. Why such a sharp change in the captain's outlook? What could he, or you, possibly say that would lead us to renounce the god hero of mankind?
No. It's not that. He doesn't want you to stop worshipping Talos. He just wants you to be more subtle, you know, for your own safety.
I see. That's... well, it's more likely to happen than asking us to renounce a divine. But why should we live in shame of our faith?
So get killed? Oh, yeah, here's the option. If you don't... oh, and this too. The Thalmor will only tighten their grip on Bruma.
I... see. That makes a lot of sense. Very well, then. We will lay low for the time being.
Sweet.
Let Adius know we're sorry for any problems that has caused for him. Or may cause him.
Hey, very understanding.
He's a good man, clearly. Any other guard captain would have handed us over to the Thalmor. No questions asked. Here he is now. Never was light on his feet.
Was that Adius? Why'd you come here?
Oh, you're still here. Good.
I just got
finally got done with all that paperwork and procedure for that damn thief Galat. So, I assume you've reached a mutual understanding? Or are you still in negotiations?
No, understanding.
Yes, Captain Adius. We're going to worship more subtly, as your messenger asked.
She's more than a messenger. She's a friend.
Aw.
But thank you for coming around. I realize it must have been tough for you to see the justification. I'm grateful, friend, that you did what I asked.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder now if it was the right call.
I have a question.
I appreciate your loyalty, but this could turn out badly. If the Thalmor have so much as an inkling that I'm shielding Talos worshippers, heads will roll. Most likely mine. And that's if they're feeling merciful. But what's done is done. There's no time for second guessing. Here's hoping we made the right call. Here's your reward. You've earned it, friend.
Well, thanks.
I guess for the time being, we go our separate ways once more. But something makes me think our paths will cross again.
I'm sure we'll.
Can I help you?
It's just, well, I have a question. If I was coming here to tell them, why did you come? Well, you could have just come yourself.
I've heard about your silver tongue. I'll let you talk your way out of an arrest, though. Bear that in mind.
Seriously? I just...
farewell?
I just helped you, and I'm your friend. Can you tell me that? Silver tongue?
Hello?
Yeah, that... They're talking like ventriloquists.
Walk always in the path of the Nine Divines.
What is it? Do not forsake the
God. We are a simple folk up here, but Divines forbid
what?
To cross us. Hello.
Hello.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. So... Find Era's Amulet of Talos in Serpent's Trail. Alright. We'll just go do that right now. And, this is a camp we can return to. Yes. Camp of the Devout. Got it. Oh, we still have to go here. Plundered Mine. I'm sure there's a bunch more places we have to go to. So still. Some more to do. Serpent's Trail this way. It is a cave. Care of that. Oh, so close. Look at that. Alright. Serpent's Trail. They stole her amulet of Talos. For that they will pay with their blood. And because they're bandits. Amethyst hates bandits. They killed her family, you see. And bandits. At least I'm expecting bandits. We're completely obscured here. Oh, here we are. What? Wait. Oh God. This is him? He's dead and buried in the snow? Lysinia Ironheart and Bruma is concerned about her husband, Harren. Harren serves in the Imperial Legion. But she hasn't heard word from him in some time. She asked me to look into it and mentioned he was last stationed at Fort Pale Pass on the Cyrodiil Skyrim border. Perhaps I should begin my search there. I don't think I need to be starting my search there. Because here he is. Harren's journal. I'll take his ring for her. Necklace of Eminent Stealing? Sneaking? Sorry. His journal. Doesn't gonna break that quest, is it? It's still... Nothing popped up. Okay. Maybe when we read the journal. Harren's journal. Where? Okay. Yep. Inform Lucinia, Elena, or Celis about Harren's fate. Optional. Lie about Harren becoming a Stormcloak. I guess for her sake. Anyway, let's read this. 8. Frostfall. Half of our legion has been ordered north of Bruma to Pale Pass to reinforce the border with Skyrim. There have been pockets of resistance throughout the province to the ban on Talos worship. That self-righteous Justiciar Armion fears that seditious thought will spread to Cyrodiil without swords to meet it, so he invoked the white gold concordat. I received the order from our commander this morning. Like I said before, if I find this guy Armian outside of Bruma, and, like, away from, like, Bruma guards and stuff, he's toast. He better hope he stays within the safety of Bruma. Because I have no qualms about killing him. I just don't want to anger all the guards and bring the whole town down on my head. I have no love for the Thalmor, but orders are orders. We depart tomorrow, but I will spend tonight with my love Lysinia and our sweet Elena. Celis has promised to continue teaching Elena to read in my stead. I don't think the old man has ever quite warmed up to me as family, but he's been a good grandfather to my daughter. 30. Frostfall. Yeah, quite a while later. We've been here for 2 weeks without incident. However, more news traveled in from Skyrim with a caravan of Khajiit. The group of Talos worshippers have declared themselves rebels against Skyrim's High King Torik. Yeah. News from Skyrim. Yep. They call themselves the Stormcloaks after their leader, Jarl Ulfric Stormcloak of Windhelm. This is when the whole rebellion started coming about. The Thalmor have locked down the border at that news. No one allowed in or out of Pale Pass, save for the Legion supply lines into Skyrim and the Thalmor's prisoners. I cannot even send word via courier to Lysinia. I watched a cart of chained Stormcloak prisoners pass through. It seems that a whole camp was taken prisoner. Do they know of the pain they are causing? Of the wounds they are reopening? The great war was fought and won. I love Talos as much as the next Nord, but his death is a small price to pay for peace. Celis may have been the one to push me to the Legion, but I enlisted to make Cyrodiil a safer place for my family. 5, I think that is, Sun's Dusk. We were on patrol when we found them. There were 5 men in the blue garb of the Stormcloaks, hanging from an old pine. The cold preserved their bodies well, but wolves had taken their legs. I recognized them from the prisoner transport. We were told they were to face trial in the Imperial City. The other men looked as sick as I felt. We knew the Legion was being lied to, taken for fools. The Thalmor are no peacekeepers. They are an occupying force. We cut them down and gave them a proper burial, marking their grave with a mound of stones. We started back to the fort to bring the news to our commanding officer, but crossed paths with a band of Thalmor. They were escorting 2 prisoners, no doubt to meet the rope. We nodded at them as we passed, trying not to betray that we had found the others, but they knew. As we passed them, they attacked us from behind, shoving their prisoners off the road. Only one of our men was lost in the end. Another 2 rushed back to the fort, naively thinking that the betrayal would be punished. I'm sure they met the same end as the hanged men. The 2 prisoners were wary of us at first, but eventually admitted that they were Stormcloaks taken prisoner at the border. Knowing that we could not return, and having seen the true face of the Thalmor, we asked to join them. The men spoke of a cave called the Serpent's Trail that led through the mountains. It would bring us to Skyrim. We set out at once. Oh, can we go back to Skyrim this way? That'd be interesting. Evening Star, 13, that's a 15, right? 15 Evening Star, this is really weird, 5. That's 5, because I think 3 kind of look like a 3. Yeah. That's a 3. Yeah, it does look different. So that must be a 5. 15 Evening Star. I've been stationed here at the mouth of Serpent's Trail for 2 weeks. It seems that my familiarity with these mountains makes me more valuable on this side of the border. I can't contact my family for fear of their safety, but one of our spies has checked in on them for me, and they seem to be well. Word has not traveled back to them of my absence. I found myself reflecting on the oath I took when I joined the Legion. Upon my honor, I swore, if I knew then what I knew now, I would have spit at those words. Mead rules only at the Thalmor's pleasure. The Empire didn't win the Great War. They just postponed our death sentence. A free Skyrim is the only place left for my family. I swear to guard the realms of men. Whatever the wall thing is. Evening Star. 29 Evening Star. An advanced scout has snuck past the border with a message. Jarl Ulfric is headed our way. If he plans to cross the border to Cyrodiil, and the Legion have caught wind. Now, I hope this doesn't end with a dot, 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 because who writes as they're being attacked and put dot, dot, dot? Let me just put another dot, and then they pass away. I dread having to turn my sword on my former Legion, but I have chosen my path. I hope that the Nine... No. I hope that Licinia can forgive me. He didn't do that thing. Okay, so let's see if we can cross into the border of Skyrim. First, we'll disarm this trap. That was painfully obvious. Because I have some claws and stuff I put in my home. I really have to unload some stuff. I should have done that before I came here. So wait. Who killed him? Bandits? That's not a Stormcloak, I don't think. Oh, he's getting freaky. That's a smuggler.